Imagine you're on a journey. Of course you're on a journey.
Singapore Airlines is de snelst groeiende luchtvaartmaatschappij ter wereld. Volgens waarnemers, maar ook volgens de luchtvaartmaatschappij zelf, speelt de air hostess daarbij een belangrijke rol.
Vriend, been here before.
In 1972 begon in Singapore een experiment. Een luchtvaartmaatschappij probeerde niet langer haar vliegreizen te promoten. Ze zouden de volgende 30 jaar een vrouw promoten.
At that time, most of the airlines, they were sort of promoting on the hardware, meaning the type of aircraft they used, the number of destinations they flew to, the frequencies they had. You know? So for Singapore Airlines, we felt that in terms of flying, the comfort is important, the comfort to passengers, the in-flight service is important. So we created this Singapore Girl image. And up till now, which is almost 30 years later, I suppose this so-called unique selling proposition is still very effective. We are trying to project this in-flight service that not only in terms of the food, the beverages, the amenities, the seats, but it's also something that comes from the heart. And the Asian value especially is very important because the so-called Asian charm, the way they're brought up, the warmth, the friendliness in attending to people.
De stewardessen van Singapore Airlines krijgen een grondige training. Deze training is belangrijk omdat de meisjes aan het beeld van de Singapore girl zouden moeten beantwoorden. Lou houdt zich vooral bezig met de selectie en de vorming.
What we're looking for is somebody who is pleasant looking. Of course, there must be no flaws, you know, as far as the appearance is concerned. Just to tie in with our advertising philosophy, we want a sort of a modern, a young fleet as well. So in terms of our crew, we feel that we want to project a young image, even in terms of service. And then for the second round, then we go more detailed in the sense that we sort of let them have, we put them in a group and let them have some group discussion and we see how they interact with each other. Because in this job, the interaction with people is very important. We also look at the way they walk again. And because, especially for the female, because the sarong kebaya is a very unique, it's a unique uniform. So we must make sure that you know, the uniform, well, the girl can fit into the uniform in that sense.
Then you check out the figure.
Yeah. Maybe I shouldn't say that. After that, they talk about sexy scenario.
We do check on like maybe birthmarks, so we are checked on that, but it's not on, I mean it's only in parts that are not covered by the uniform, so it's just to show, it's just to have a good, you know, like, you know, we always emphasize on Singapore girl, so we must have a good image. You got to be slim and you got to be fairly attractive and with a good smile and a very good, I mean sometimes from outside you could see a person's personality.
Er zitten niet alleen meisjes in de selectiegroep, ook Calvin is kandidaat.
The selection is very gruesome. It's like you're going to a beauty pageant. Yeah, it keeps you on your toes because there's so many people, and what you see is the cream of the crop, I guess. Yeah, everyone, I guess they are very, very choiced in their selection, and I'm just glad that, you know, they managed to pick me.
Een belangrijk moment bij de selectie is de zwemtest. Die mochten we niet filmen. Volgens Singapore Airlines is de test er alleen uit veiligheidsoverwegingen.
And is it just to see if they can swim? To be honest.
To see that they can swim and well. To be honest. Very hard sometimes to be honest. Yeah, I suppose it's also to look at the way they walk. Huh?
And the way they look.
The way they look.
Use what you have, because you are a lady. What is your weapon? Excuse me, sir, madam. Would you please help me with the tray? Your mouth. Your mouth is your weapon, okay? All right.
Stuart Howard van de Internationale Transportvakbond heeft zijn bedenkingen bij de manier waarop Singapore Airlines vrouwen gebruikt om haar imago gestalte te geven.
What we also find is that certain carriers in Southeast Asia put a particular twist on the way in which they market their airline tickets, where they combine certain images of women with certain cultural images of Orientalism, which they manufacture through the uniforms, through the advertising, to present a certain kind of image which reinforces a stereotype of a Southeast Asian woman as being more compliant to male demands, more attendant on male demands. And this is an image which is actively promoted by the airlines and which, as I say, makes this particular twist which affects Asian women.
If you look at our training, it is a very comprehensive training, because which other company will provide such a full training on food, wine, equipment, safety, passenger handling, even how to look after babies. And I think it basically it sort of brings up the best and the beauty of a lady.
More than university?
Sorry?
More than university? More than let's say...
Of course, yeah, of course. Because university, because you just basically you study a particular subject, yeah? Whereas down here is really the people part of it. And when they start flying, it's really the real world, how to look after people.
So it's an ideal training for a woman?
Of course.
I find that we are trained in this way, in a way they try to inculcate us with the personality of what the Singapore girl is supposed to have. Yeah.
And what do you need to have? This extra touch, what is it?
Well, I guess it's difficult to really spell it out in words. But as I go through the training, I have this kind of feeling like, how should I behave?
De training gaat erg ver. De studenten moeten zich volledig inpassen in een aparte leefwereld. De wereld van Singapore Airlines.
I've been through training for about 6-7 weeks now. And I think eventually the training sort of molds you. For one thing, I feel that I've become a better person and I've learned to understand people more better. And I guess the stress on training has put another identity on Singapore Airline Gold as well.
Some of them, in fact, came back to tell us that even their parents cannot recognize them. And I think the important part is also how they carry themselves, the behavior part, which is very important, because that is not easy. So in order to achieve that, we sort of watch them carefully, even outside classrooms. For instance, we will be very concerned if a stewardess, after office hours, you know, after duty hours, she will go to a nightclub or disco and misbehave herself. Because, you know, we always stress to them that even at the overseas stations, they are still on the company time. So basically, we are actually trying to get them to become somebody who is a better person, so to speak.
Well, I believe that if you believe in what the company believes, you will be happier. Because
you're not only working, but you're actually doing what you really like to do.
Er is bij Singapore Airlines een groot verschil tussen stewards en stewardessen. De vrouwen kunnen er maar voor een korte tijd werken.
For stewardesses, the average length of service, I would say, usually is about 5 years after one contract is finished. Usually.
We're given full 5-year contract. Yeah. So after the 5-year contract, you're given another 5-year contract, and it goes on.
Do you know which contract the steward gets?
I think it's about the same. It's about the same. Yeah.
Maar het is helemaal niet hetzelfde. Stewards blijven in dienst tot ze met pensioen gaan.
Stewards can get a kind of an open-ended contract.
Yes.
Can you explain me the difference?
The stewards, because as I said, because most of them, they take it as a career. Okay. So we just allow them to work up to the maximum, which is 55 years, if they're promoted to the higher ranks. Whereas for the female, because we want them to, in a sense, that renew the contract after 5 years. I'm also lost. Yeah, this part is a bit sensitive issue. I don't know whether you want to include that.
Het imago van de Singapore girl en de strikte arbeidsvoorwaarden voor de meisjes hebben andere luchtvaartmaatschappijen aan het denken gezet. Zo is ook Thai Airways enkele jaren geleden van tactiek veranderd. Het had verstrekkende gevolgen voor de stewardessen.
The Thai management decided to change the policy because of Thai was on top. We were top 10. And suddenly Singapore Airlines became on top. But the way of Thai management look at Singapore, they think young and beauty of the Singapore cabin crew, Singapore girl and the cabin crew. So they change because they like Thai to be like that. The Thai cabin crew should be young and beauty too. Most of the Singapore girls are beautiful. I accept it. And young. Some of them very young. I never see the old age of Singapore girls. But I think Thai try to, compare their employee with Singapore Airlines in this matter. But I don't know their Singapore policy about this. But I always see the Singapore, make any propaganda or the whatever about Singapore Airlines with the girls. It's always on television, the picture, everywhere in the world, Singapore girls.
I feel pity on them because they have to show themselves to the customer. I feel pity on the Singapore girl. Why they do nothing, or why they apply for such an airline that to sell appeal of the woman for their commercial, for the airline.
The first women who were employed on board aircraft were trained nurses, and that was seen as their primary role. They were there for safety assistance for passengers on board the aircraft. That rapidly changed as we entered the era of mass travel on board aircraft. And you can see it in the name given for the role, for that job, where the name air hostess quickly starts to get adopted, or stewardess.
I think it's wrong. It should not focus on that. We should focus on the safety, that we, Thai cabin crew are professional for safety that we can provide to the passengers, to our customer, not young and beauty. That we should be the hero in Asia to focus that way.
Safety experts now are agreed, after analysing a number of aviation accidents, that the safety role of cabin crew is paramount. That's the reason they're on board. Their primary role is not serving drinks, is not handing out newspapers. It is to check equipment on board the aircraft. It's to ensure that passenger behaviour doesn't threaten the safety of the flight. And it's to ensure that evacuations are carried out in the safe and as speedy a possible manner. That's the role of cabin crew. They are safety professionals. They are not hostesses.
In 1990, the policy of Thai Airways changed the retirement age of female cabin crew from 60 years old to 45 years old, because one of the board of management said in the public that to be good cabin crew, no need to have brain, no need to be clever. Young and beautiful is enough to be a good cabin crew. That is their idea, but for me, I don't think that. In my experience, young and beautiful can't do anything on board. You can't treat passengers well. You don't even know what the passengers want. For us, experience is the most important. I know when I see at the passengers' eyes, I know suddenly what they want. That's because of my experience.
Vara Porn werkt nog maar 3 jaar bij Thai Airways. Ze is mooi en jong. Van haar geen enkel slecht woord over het imago van Thai Airways.
I feel great. I'm proud of my company and proud to be a part of Thai Airways. We grow up with the culture, Thai culture, and inside our heart, you know, like people is the important things that make Thai become the best airline.
Some of the passengers may be Chinese. They don't know that some of us can speak Chinese, can understand Chinese. They said, okay, this girl, tonight, okay, I pay $50. And you see, he told his friends, sit beside, that, you see, okay, I pay $50 and I know I will sleep with her. Everybody laughed. And when the passengers talked to her like this, she felt that she's a precious girl. And she's just, nobody can protect her. That means every man think of the air hostess like this. So she's very angry and she put the very hot coffee pot on the passenger's lap. And now she's quit this job.
Once a cabin crew member is up there in the air, there's no escape. They're very isolated. And they cannot simply walk out of the work environment in the way that anybody else can in virtually any other work environment.
If anything happened to you, you have to take care of yourself. The company don't do anything. Even some of the passengers touch your bottom, and the company said, it's none of their business. I mean, it's your business. If you let the passengers touch their bottom or kiss you in the toilet or something like that, it's your duty. Don't take any serious.
Bing Ham is bij Thai Airways verantwoordelijk voor de opleiding van nieuwe stewardessen. Volgens haar is het nu eenmaal zo dat bepaalde dingen eigen zijn aan de job van een stewardess.
I had that question too. Hey, I want to sleep with you. Come on, sit here. How much? Ask me. They just try. You see, if I were a man, I try. If I think that, this girl is my type, I think that this is, why not? Yeah. I try. But if no, it's no. If yes, maybe. Because it's this kind of job, you know, it's just you have to meet people.
Net als Porn Pimon vreest Shamri ontslagen te worden als ze straks 45 wordt.
This picture was taken 16 years ago when I was 28 years old. And now I'm 44. I joined Thai 20 years. The company expect all the cabin to keep fit as the first time they joined Thai, which is impossible. But you can see from the picture and myself now that it's not much different. I can still work for Thai Airways International. I am sure that I'm not that ugly, too ugly to work or too old to work. A lot of my friends try to eat less or don't eat dinner, don't eat any meat, try to get slim or don't want to get fat, drink Diet Coke. They're afraid to get fired and they don't want to be fat because to be fat is not good at all.
If you're fat, getting fat, I think it is not nice for wearing a uniform. And this is about the safety. How can you help passenger if something happens? Because it's I think that if we compare about the normal one and the fat one, I think that the way to active about the working is different. So we have the what we call is the penalties, so maybe written warning, and 25% of your salary will be deducted for 1 month. And if a lot of report for this steward or stewardess, I think that you resign.
ถ้าครูเดินทางไปจาการ์ตาครูถามว่าเวลานี้จาการ์ตา UTC เท่าไหร่
We made the sticker to put on every bag of cabin crew. We try to distribute this to all the cabin crew, male and female. And some of our colleagues put them on the customers when they load the bag at the cargo compartment.And they put them in the customer bag, and we put in the bag, the small bag and the big bag, the luggage, and all the people see. And a lot of them ask what happened in Thai Airways, and it works.
Farah Porn heeft echter nog nooit gehoord van de actie van haar twee collega's. Zij denkt nog niet aan het afscheid.
I think 45 is enough for the girl. Because after 45, I think maybe your health is not good enough, you know, like you a little bit old, too old. Here is where we have to do the check-in procedure. First of all, you have to check your name in the computer. After that, you have to sign your name on the counter there, and we have some supervisor to check all my appearance. Yeah, they've already made.